Well, if you think you're buying foods that are good for you, in reality, they could be filled with other ingredients you may not even know about, and you could also be getting ripped off at the same time.
Fish, olive oil, honey, and wine. Items on your grocery list, but you may be buying something else. Experts call it economically motivated adulteration, or simply food fraud.
About 10% of the food you buy on the grocery shelf is probably adulterated.
Meaning it's mislabeled, diluted, or misrepresented. Some of the biggest culprits, fish products.
You think you're getting crab, you're getting fake crab.
Some fish are more expensive than others. If this was labeled grouper, could you tell it's catfish?
Fruit juices.
In some cases, pomegranate juice has been found to be nothing more than water, citric acid, and red food coloring.
Sometimes juice is labeled as fresh squeezed when it's really made from concentrate.
Olive oil.
Experts say 65% of extra virgin olive oil tested at grocery stores is actually diluted with lower grade oil.
Consumers have almost gotten used to this flavor, these off flavors that reflect the defects that you find in bad olive oil. Off flavors such as rancidity, there's some called musty, which has kind of a damp basement flavor.
And honey.
We now have the problem of honey laundering.
That's right, honey laundering, where honey from countries with trade embargoes is shipped through approved countries, then sent to the United States. Expired infant formula and wine are also on the list of fake or mislabeled products.
They got it right the wrong. They're lying to us. You know, that's not right.
I think they should make it more explicit on the label, that so a consumer can come in and look and quickly know what they're buying.
Researchers say food fraud costs the U.S. $10 to $15 billion a year, and counterfeiters rake in the cash.
I think the question comes down to enforcement and clear standards, and the U.S. right now has neither.
In the end, just as in any problem with food, if there's a problem, it's the consumer who pays, either a higher price or through illness.
Now, the FDA requires all food labels to accurately indicate what's contained in the food, and the agency issues a warning to manufacturers if it finds mislabeled or misrepresented products, and the products that do not fall into compliance can ultimately be pulled from the shelves. So the key is for consumers, Wolf, is that you buy trusted brands, and if the price on some items seem too good to be true, it probably is.
Sometimes good advice. Thanks very much, Sandy, for that report.